So good morning to all of you. Hello.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Okay. Just I am checking where you are listening or not. Okay. So today we are first with the help of PPT. So are you seeing this PPT? Hello?
Hi, sir.
Huh? Yes or no?
No, sir.
This day, na? PPT this day, ka?
No, sir. No.
No? Okay. Just a minute, I will close all the things and then so now you are seeing the PPT.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just I am making it big. So study of financial statements. In the last week, we are discussed some important issues or concepts regarding the study of financial statements. And today we are going to discuss some important things that are to be vertical form of financial statements. So don't make any lines, red lines or any others, nobody. On the PPT, there is one line which is given by anybody. So don't make these things. So vertical form of financial statements, when we are studying the financial statements, the balance sheet, profit and loss account, it can be converted into vertical form. So need of vertical format, why there is a need of vertical format when we are going to study the financial statements? As you have studied, the T form of balance sheet or the traditional form of balance sheet. The balance sheet have two sides. One is liability side and another is asset side. And that is known as T form or traditional form or the horizontal form. Now, this form is suitable to the owners, those who are preparing the financial statements. So partnership form, company, cooperative societies, or any other business organizations, they are prepare the financial statement or balance sheet in the form of horizontal, that is T form. But when we are going to analyze it, not financial analysis is to be possible because of the horizontal or traditional form of the balance sheet. And that is why when we can analyze it, when we can study detail, at that time, the horizontal or traditional format of balance sheet can be converted into vertical format. So what is vertical format? It is one of the method or technique in which the financial statements are to be prepared or made in the vertical format. Now T format, assets and liabilities are, that is two sides are there. But in the vertical format, one by one we are recording by preparing the columns like particulars, then debit amount and credit amount. So these things are to be there in the vertical form of balance sheet. The vertical form of balance sheet, when we are going to prepare it while solving the problem, then you well known about it. But I can explain. Now, when the vertical form of balance sheet is to be prepared, there are three columns. First column is particulars, another column is inner amount, and third column is outer amount. Now, it is like to be a particular statement or the table in which three columns are to be involved or three columns are to be prepared. And one by one, when we are started the vertical form of balance sheet to prepare, the vertical form of balance sheet is to be started from the liability side. So liabilities we are knowing, liability side we are knowing very well. And the first heading or the main heading is given for the vertical form of balance sheet is, I am giving the instruction that nobody can make some lines on the PPT. Somebody has making the lines, so don't make it. Vertical form of balance sheet starts from the liability side, and the main headings on the liability side are we now discussed here. Now, Roman 1, in the particulars we are writing Roman 1. The heading is equity and liabilities. So whatever may be the equity, that is a liability side, various types of headings that starts from the equity and liabilities. It is also known as sources of funds. And equity and liabilities, we are knowing that a company can format or make a capital available through the equity share hold, that is equity share and the preference shares, and that is known as shareholders funds. Now, equity share capital, when issued by the company, the equity share capital is to be known as own capital of the company. That means when any new company or the existing company are issued the shares to the public, the persons, those who are holding that share, it can become the owner or shareholder of the company. And when the shares are to be issued or purchased by the particular person, then he become a owner for a long period of time. Nobody can sell the particular shares if the prices of the particular shares are to be increased. And that is why if 10 rupees shares is to be purchased and 100 shares are to be purchased, then after 5 years, 10 years, these 10 rupees face value share can become be 100 rupees, 200 rupees, 500 rupees per share. So it is an increasing one. Now share market is very important. When the company can issue the shares in the market, at the initial stage, the amount of share is very less. Face value is very less. 10 rupees, 50 rupees, 100 rupees, whatever may be. Then when the company can become popular, when the company can perform the duties very well, activities are doing very well, and profit is to be earned by the company in a better way, then the prices of equity shares from 10 rupees, I can say again, if you are purchasing 10 rupees share, it can become 100 rupees, 200 rupees, 400, 500, whatever may be. So this is because if you are investing only 10 rupees, but after 5 years, after 10 years, it can be increased by 10 times, again 20 times as per the performance of the company. And that is why the liability side, which is started from the equity and liabilities, and in that shareholders funds are to be recorded first. Shareholders funds, that is to be recorded, issued, subscribed, called up and paid up shares. Under this, suppose 10,000 shares of rupees 100 each are to be issued by the company, then 10 lakhs amount of the particular equity share capital is to be recorded in inner column amount. So in the particulars, this information is given that 10,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each, and the amount is to be recorded in inner column 10 lakhs rupees. And after the equity share, preference share capital is also raised by the company. That is, preference share are to be issued by the company. If the adequate equity capital is not to be raised by the company, so it is one of the option that the equity share capital is a own capital. The equity shareholders are the owners of the company, and that is why when they are purchasing all the shares, at the moment when the company is to be going into liquidation, they are remaining the shareholders of the company. So if any company is working for, we can say, so many years, 10 years, 15 years, 25 years, or like that, all these are to be maintained or kept in a better way. And that is why the equity shareholders are the real owners, and they can remain with the company up to the existing of that particular company. But if there are some limitations on equity share capital, raising the equity share capital, then the company can use another option, that is a preference share capital. The preference shares are to be issued by the company to the public also, but the preference shareholders are not the real owners. That is why the persons who can purchase the preference shares, they can get the dividend at a fixed rate of amount. 10% preference shares, 12% preference shares, 15% preference shares we are writing. Then whatever may be the percentage is given accordingly, if the 10% preference shares are there, the shareholder can get 10% interest fixed amount year after year. Then if the 12% preference shares are there, the preference shareholders can get 12% interest on that year after year. So this is a one of the fixed return or income based capital, and those persons who are required, we want a fixed rate of return on the capital, then they can purchase the preference shares. And those who are not required, the fixed rate of dividend, they are purchasing the equity shares. But when the profit is increased, when the profit is raised, then the equity shareholders can getting high amount of dividend, but the preference shareholders are not getting that. So there is a risk in the equity share capital. If there is no profit, no dividend is to be declared. And if the company can have the more profit, then the equity shareholders are getting more the dividend on their investment. So this is the difference between equity shares and preference shares. So these are to be shown in the shareholders' funds. Now 10 lakhs rupees, I have told you that equity share capital is to be there. And suppose 5,000, 10% preference shares of rupees 100 each to be sold or issued by the company, then preference share capital becomes 5 lakhs. So this 10 lakhs and 5 lakhs, we are recording to the outer column total 15 lakhs. And then B part is there, that is reserves and surplus, which are to be recorded after sources of funds. Now reserves and surplus, various types of reserves and surplus are recorded under this head. So B head is given here, in which general reserve, capital reserve, then some compensation reserve, other capital reserves. So which reserves are there? Sinking fund reserve, then development reserve. The name reserve, when you can see, it is to be included in the reserves and surplus. So this amount is to be again recorded in inner column. Say for example, general reserve amount is rupees 25,000. Sinking fund reserve account, that is amount is 1 lakh. Then capital reserve is 1 lakh. So all the amounts that are to be totaled. And suppose all the reserves and surplus amount is becomes again 5 lakhs. Suppose it is 5 lakhs. Then less fictitious assets. So fictitious assets are given on the asset side. These are to be identified very well. When the assets side, the last, in the last or bottom of the particular balance sheet, these assets are given. Suppose preliminary expenses are given, then discount on of issue of shares and debentures is given, then underwriter's commission is given, profit and loss account debit balance is given. These are known as fictitious assets. These are not actual assets. These are not actual assets, but these are fictitious, hidden assets. And that is why the name is given fictitious assets. We are not seen what is a profit and loss account. We are not seen what is a underwriter's commission. We are not seen the preliminary expenses. We are not seen also the discount on issue of shares and debentures. So which is not seen, that is to be known as fictitious assets, and which are to be deducted from the reserves and surplus. Just I have told you the reserves and surplus amount is rupees 5 lakhs, then if the fictitious assets are rupees 2 lakhs, so from the 5 lakhs, 2 lakhs rupees are to be deducted and outer column 3 lakhs are to be recorded. So first, equity capital 10 lakhs, preference share capital 5 lakhs, and these 3 lakhs by deducting fictitious assets, then all the totals of the liability comes 18 lakhs. All the total of liability becomes 18 lakhs, which is known as total capital employed. So total capital that is to be, that is own funds, that means these funds are not taken from any company, that is own funds. Equity capital and reserve capital is own funds. Then second part or second Roman, we can say here, the long-term borrowings are given. So in the long-term borrowings, now equity share fund, preference share capital and reserves and surplus, that is the own capital, own funds of the company. But on particular development or project enhancement, some additional amount or borrowed funds are to be required to the company, and that is known as long-term borrowings. Now these long-term borrowings are having secured loans. Secured loans means which loans are given some mortgage by the company, that are known as secured loans. Under this, debentures comes. So debentures, again, 10% debentures, 12% debentures, 15% debentures. That means the debentures are carrying fixed rate of interest. 10% means 12%. 12% debentures mean interest is 12%. 15% debentures means interest is 15%, like that. Then other bonds, that is government bond, Kisan Vikas Patra, Indira Vikas Patra, that is all other, that is bonds, are also to be issued by the company, and that is the borrowed capital. Then bank loan is also taken. Bank loan from the nationalized banks, some loans are to be taken by the company that are also have some mortgage. Property is given as mortgage. If the company has a property of rupees 1 crore and they require 50 lakhs of the particular amount as a loan, then easily the banks can given the loan of rupees 50 lakhs against the mortgage of 1 crore building or property. So such types of things are there in the bank loan. Then again, loan from financial institutions. Now some financial institutions are provide particular loan to the companies. Say for example, if there is a business or company, then ICICI banks, that is loan from ICICI, it is a financial institution. Then IDBI, Industrial Development Bank of India, other State Finance Corporation, SFC, then National Finance Corporation. So all R comes, then LIC, then other institutions. From that also, the company can raise the capital that is known as borrowed, which is taken from others, financial institutions or banks, that is a borrowed capital. And then other loans are there. In the other loans, sometimes if the bank or the financial institutions are not given the loans to the company, then other government, we can say bodies, government institutions, they are giving the loans to the particular company, that comes under the other loans. So these are secured because mortgage is given. And in the B part again, unsecured loans, on which loans no security is given, no mortgage is given, that is known as unsecured loan. Now for this, if the company is not paying the amount within a particular period of time, then the particular institution has no any right to forfeit the properties of the company. So in the secured loan, what happens if you are given the building as a security and if the company is not paying that amount, then the financial institution can forfeit that particular building. It can be sold, the auction is made, and the amount can be recovered by the bank from the particular company. That's why it is known as secured loans. In the unsecured loans, there is no security. If the company is not paying amount, then the financial institution, bank, or any other cannot do anything because there is no security. And that is why it is known as unsecured loans. Again, here, all the above are included. Debentures, bonds, banks loan, loan from FC, financial institutions and other loan. And instead of that, public deposits. Now, sometimes the companies can accept the public deposits and public can also invest some amount in the companies, because if any individual person is investing in the bank, bank can give you 7%, 8% or maximum 10% interest on that. But if the company can give you 12% interest, 13% interest, then persons are attracted towards keeping the deposits in the banks. And that is known as public deposits, which are to be accepted by the particular company. Then loan from directors. Directors are also given loan to the company. If any persons, financial institutions or others, they are not given the loan to the company, then directors are also provided some loan to the company, and that is comes under the unsecured loan. Now, when secured and unsecured, both the total seeds come again, I can say 18 lakhs, first of all, their own funds are there, and all these again, 7 lakhs from the long-term borrowings, 7 lakhs rupees are to be raised by the company, then 18 lakhs plus 7 lakhs, that is 25 lakhs is the total capital employed by the company. Just I have given in the bracket, that is equity capital, that is Roman 1 plus Roman 2, that is own funds plus borrowed funds is equal to total capital employed. So own funds are 15 lakhs and borrowed funds are, 18 lakhs and 7 lakhs, then total capital employed is to be 25 lakhs. This is the total of liability side. This is the total of liability side. Now, it is to be very clear, whatever may be shown on the liability side in the traditional balance sheet, that are we can make here in the vertical form. The main headings you observe here, see here, that whatever may be the headings are there, you can keep in mind that these are the main headings of the liability side. And under that, you can record the particular items. So it is very simple, only writing on the liability side as usual. Here only the format is changed. Sources of funds are equity and liabilities. The first heading is given, and in that, equity share capital, preference share capital, then reserves and surplus, ETCS assets are to be deducted, then total becomes own capital, then long-term borrowings are there, debentures, bonds, bank loan, loan from financial institutions, again unsecured is there. So whatever may be the raised funds are to be raised, that are to be recorded, and that total of rupees 25 lakhs, just I have told you, that is to be taken as a total capital employed. Now, you can always have the question in your mind. The liability side has also the current liabilities, but these are not taken in the vertical form of balance sheet in the equity and liabilities. So very important thing is that your doubt or your question may be in the mind that liability side we are recorded in the TIP or traditional format on the liability side. current liabilities and provisions, then sundry creditors, bills payables, bank overdraft, outstanding wages, outstanding rent, advance payment of others. So whatever may be, we are recorded in the liability side as well as in the provisions. Provision for income tax, provision for dividend. So everything we are recorded on the liability side. But one more thing is very important, that up to the total capital employed, we can take only that items. And now in the next PPT, I will show you that what is to be taken in the asset side. Now continued, I have continued it. The asset side or applications of funds. This can be started from the liability, that is asset side. Asset side, what's main heads we are studied in the traditional format. There are fixed assets. In the fixed assets, land and building, plant and machinery, furniture and fixture. So other motor vehicles, railway slidings, then various types of animals, horses, these are also comes in the fixed assets. Then investment is given, then other current assets are given. In that, debtors, bills receivables, stock or many others. That is why if the balance sheet of assets and liabilities can be become equal. But we are now converted it into vertical format. It can be converted into vertical format. That is, main heading is given. When you are making the total, just I am going back again. When we are making the total, 1 minute. So total capital employed, whatever may be the liability side, is total, that is to be considered. And in the asset side, the asset side is to be started with the applications of funds. Now in the sources of funds, liability side, there are sources of funds. How you are raise the funds to the company, that's why it is to be known as sources of funds. And application of funds means how these funds are to be utilized. Utilized by purchasing the land and building, by purchasing plant and machinery, by purchasing other assets. And that's why it is to be known as application of funds. Now, these applications of funds, the heading starts with the application of funds from the asset side. And in that again, Roman one, small Roman one, tangible assets. Now there are fixed assets, and fixed assets are having two types of assets. Tangible assets. Now tangible assets means which assets we have seen and touch, that assets are known as tangible assets. So we can see the plant and machinery, land and building, all other motor vehicles, animals, and that is why it is to be known as tangible, which is seen and which is to be touched. We can touch to the building, we can touch to the plant and machinery, and then we can touch to the furniture, and that is why that assets are known as tangible assets. Under this, land and building comes, plant and machinery comes, furniture and fixture comes, vehicles comes, livestock, just I have told you, buffaloes are there, horses are there, elephants are there, goats are there. So whatever may be the company's production, accordingly, the livestock is to be kept by the company as an asset. If any, we can say company is in the production of the milk product, various types of milk products are to be made or manufactured by the company, then company can keep its buffaloes. The buffaloes are livestock, and sometimes if company is engaged in the particular sports activity, then they can keep the horses for races. Horses are used for races. Then we can say the farmers are using the bullock carts. There are some bullock carts, races are also there. So whatever may be the livestock, that livestock can be included in the tangible assets. And other fixed assets are intangible. Which assets we cannot see or we cannot touch, that assets are known as intangible asset. Now under this asset, goodwill comes, patents comes, copyrights comes, trademarks comes, computer software comes. So these are the intangible assets. Goodwill we can't see. Then patents we can't see. Copyrights also we can't see. Then trademarks and other things we can't see. And computer software can also we can't see. So that is intangible assets. So whatever may be the land and building, total amount we can say becomes 5 lakhs. Intangible assets become 1 lakh. So total becomes 6 lakhs. Then investment, the particular head after the tangible and intangible assets, investment is recorded separately. If it is rupees 3 lakhs, so 5 lakhs and 3 lakhs, 8 lakhs. Then current assets, whatever may be the current assets are given. In the current assets, debtors, bills receivables, and many other cash, stock, or other assets that are to be recorded in the current assets, and less current liabilities. Now these current liabilities are to be deducted from current assets. These are from liability side, but these are to be deducted from the current assets in the balance sheet applications of fund. So they are to be taken from liability side and directly deducted from the current assets. So this is one important thing which you may always keep in mind. So current liabilities, sundry creditors, bills payables, then other liabilities, that comes under the current liabilities. So current assets and current liabilities, whatever may be the total comes, that is known as working capital. So if it is again rupees 5 lakhs, so 8 and 5 lakhs, 13 lakhs are coming, then other liabilities, that is to be, again I have mentioned here, what are the other liabilities are to be there. That total again we can say 8, 5, 13 and 12. If this is the 25 lakhs total, then assets 25 lakhs, liabilities total capital employed 25 lakhs, then our problem is tallied. So this total of assets is known as net worth. Asset side total heading is given net worth, and the liability side total is given total capital employed. So total capital employed, here I have mentioned here, see, own funds plus borrowed funds is equal to total capital. Now what is the similarity? If the total capital employed total comes 25 lakhs and the net worth becomes 25 lakhs, that means balance sheet is tally. But this is in vertical format. It is not in traditional format. So on the basis of, we can say whatever we are learned from the 11th standard, then 12th standard, FY level, and now you are at SY level, the vertical form of balance sheet is to be prepared. In the financial accounting and management, we are preparing the traditional format balance sheet, final accounts of the partnership firm. But in the management accounting, we cannot prepare the traditional form of income statement and balance sheet. It is to be prepared in the vertical format. And that is the format which can have these heads. It starts with the liability side and ends with the asset side. And then the totals are there in the case of particular form of balance sheet. So I think some idea, some prelim knowledge, some basic things you may know from this discussion. So it is a very simple, when you have fixed that particular format of the balance sheet as well as of the income statement, then easily you can convert the traditional form of income statement, profit and loss account, and the balance sheet into vertical format. So problems are to be asked here, that problems are given in the traditional format. Trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet of the company is given, and you are asked to convert the same into vertical format. So profit and loss account, trading account, whatever may be the totals are there, net profit is there, then balance sheet asset side and balance sheet liability side totals are there. Only we can arrange it, rearrange it in the vertical format. And what is the gross profit which is shown from the trading account in the problem, that can be shown in the income statement. So some that traditional format madhe gross profit jar problem madhe 150,000 dila asel, tar apla income statement jeva apan tayar karu तेव्हा तिथे देखील तो 150,000 रुपये आला म्हणजे आपला प्रॉब्लेम बरोबर आहे असं समजायचं. तिकडे 150,000 दिला आणि इकडे 140,000 झाला तर आपली कुठेतरी गडबड झाली असं समजायचं. त्यानंतर नेट प्रॉफिट जो आहे, प्रॉफिट अँड लॉस अकाउंट शोज द नेट प्रॉफिट. ते एक्सपेन्सेस जे असतील डेबिटचे प्रॉफिट अँड लॉस अकाउंटचे, ते इन्कम स्टेटमेंट मध्ये आपल्याला त्या पद्धतीने वजा करायचे असतात. आणि जेव्हा ट्रेडिशनल फॉर्मैट मधला नेट प्रॉफिट जेवड़ा है तेवड़ा इनकम स्टेटमेंट वर्टिकल फॉर्म मधला दाखवत असेल. समजा हा 50,000 नेट प्रॉफिट है ट्रेडिशनल फॉर्मैट मधला, तो आपल्याला इनकम स्टेटमेंट मध्ये देखील 50,000 आला पाहिजे, तेवड़ा दिसला पाहिजे. म्हणजे हे इनकम स्टेटमेंट आणि पुन्हा बैलेंस शीट अशा पद्धतीने. मुद्दा मी पहिले बैलेंस शीट घेतलंय कारण बैलेंस शीटचं प्रिपरेशन अगोदर होतं आणि नंतर इन्कम स्टेटमेंटचं प्रिपरेशन होतं. पुढच्या तासाला आपण इन्कम स्टेटमेंटचा व्हर्टिकल फॉर्मॅट बघू, तो कसा असतो, त्याच्यामध्ये काय काय असतं, हे आपण नंतरच्या तासाला बघू. टुडेज टाइम इज ओव्हर नाउ. आय हॅव सम एक्झाम ऑफ द टी वाय बीकॉम एज वेल एज एमकॉम टुडे. ऑनलाईन एक्झाम्स आर देअर. सो बिफोर टाइम आय एम स्टॉप हिअर and the lecture is to be completed. On Monday we are having the lecture, second lecture. Aahe ka konakade time table aahe? Tumhi time table chhevat nahi tumchyakade?
Aahe.
Yes, pahila period aahe somvari. Pahilas period aahe 8:30 la. तर 8:30 ला आपण मॅनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंगचा व्हर्टिकल फॉर्मॅट इन्कम स्टेटमेंट बघू आणि त्याच्यानंतर तुम्हाला मी फॉर्मॅट बुक मधले तुमचे जे फोटो असतील ते पाठवून देईन, ते तुम्ही तुमच्या वहीमध्ये लिहा. अगोदर डिस्कशन करतोय आणि नंतर ते फॉर्मॅट तुम्ही वहीमध्ये लिहून काढा आणि मग आपण प्रॉब्लेमला सुरुवात करू. ओके, टुडे वी कॅन स्टॉप हिअर. वी कॅन मीट अगेन ऑन मंडे. आपण सोमवारी जो काय आपला पीरियड आहे त्या पीरियडला आपण भेटूया आणि वर्टिकल फॉर्म ऑफ इन्कम स्टेटमेंट या दिवशी आपण लक्षात घेऊ. ओके, बाय, टेक केअर.
ओके सर,
सगळ्यांनी काळजी घ्या, आरोग्याची काळजी घ्या.